Greetings, travelers, and welcome to a new series I'm going to be starting called VG Art Review. In this series, I'm going to be taking a look at three separate titles, evaluating them for their artistic content, and how well that content plays into the mechanics of the actual game, whether I find it effective or not. Starting with our first game is Kami. Kami is a game with a simple concept but progressively complex puzzles. The goal of each level is to fill the screen with one solid color. This is done by clicking one of the colors along the bottom, then clicking any one square on the screen. This color will then fold out into touching squares of the same color as the one initially clicked. The visuals are clean and simple, using textures of actual paper for a more tactile feel. The visual style is consistent throughout the game, but the natural feel of the paper felt disjointed from the clean, unadorned style of the UI and its subsequent controls. It feels very satisfying to click a square and watch all adjacent squares fold over into their new color. It does seem as though the idea of Japanese paper, which is known for its intricate methods of turning something 2D, in this case paper, into a 3D form, was a very loose jumping point for which the game is based, as the folding is only done upon a single plane. Kami, having been self-described as created in a Japanese theme, falls a bit flat in regards to that goal. Despite any missed execution in visuals, none of that detracts from the experience as a whole, and Kami proves to be a great game for quick 5-minute breaks and has all the elements that would translate it well into mobile platforms. Steamworld Dig is a 2D platformer where at its heart you dig gems and use said gems to buy newer and better equipment. The deeper you dig, the harder the rock gets and the sharper the pickaxe you will need. Along the way, you will find upgrades in a Metroidvania-esque manner, which will allow you to access new areas and navigate your tunnels easier and more efficiently. Steamworld Dig feels sharp and well drawn even at full 1080p resolution. The vector style drawings aid in the scalability, keeping everything clean at any scale, including the well-detailed motion portraits. The sharp edges and jagged transitions help with the idea of this town and corresponding mineshaft feel tense and full of danger. Elements such as lighting effects down in the mines deviate from this a little, but do not detract from the atmosphere, as your lantern has limited fuel and the darkness presses in with every passing second. Audio elements felt appropriate, but the music felt extremely repetitive after an hour, as there seemingly was only a single track for the mine and a slightly different one for the town. I did not notice any changes in music as I descended deeper into the mine as any sort of cue for depth. Overall, the execution of Steamworld Dig's art direction felt complete and without distraction. By solving some of the repetitiveness of the resources, the game could enhance immersion and avoid potential tedium. One40 is a true minimalistic style game of timing, patterns, and audio cues. You are not a hero in some epic quest to save anyone. You are a basic shape, changing from a square while still, a circle while moving, and a triangle when jumping. The goal of each level is simply to collect the two-color dot and return it to a sort of holding spot, denoted by a half circle on the ground. You are given no menus, no instructions, and yet none are needed in this beautifully simple game. As soon as you figure out your ability to move, everything else just seems to fall into place. I am no expert when it comes to music, but it'd be fair to describe 140's music as a mix of electronic and trance. It can be repetitive, but in such a way that it makes sense, as physical elements are meant to be timed with the audio. After each collection of bicolored pip, the music changes slightly, adding in new layers and removing others. It adds an organic feel to an otherwise generally geometric scene. It can be said that some attempts at a minimalistic theme are a hit and a miss, as it instead just feels lacking. But Carlson Games' ability to skillfully pull this off is worthy of being commended. If you're looking for a fun but moderately challenging puzzle platformer, I suggest you check out 140. And that concludes this episode of VG Art Review. I'll be trying to get these episodes out weekly, reviewing three separate games as I find them. I will be focusing more on the indie level of games, but if I find a particularly stunning mainstream game, I'll take a look at it as well. I just find the indie games tend to have a bit more art focus and incorporate the art more into the actual mechanics of the games. So if you enjoyed this episode, don't forget to like and subscribe. Let us know we're doing something right and lets you know when the next episode comes out. Have a good day, everyone. Bye-bye.